6.5 KECO in Elk City, Oklahoma, 7:07 on a finally Thursday. Are you ready for some football? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Are you ready for the football?
Are you ready for the football?
Remember that time Chris Farley spoke to Congress, to the House of Representatives or something?
Yeah.
By the way, I'm hearing myself really well now.
Did he speak as himself
well,
or was he in a character?
I don't remember if he may have been Huey Long or
Huey Lewis?
Newt Gingrich. Or who was always...
Was he the motivational speaker?
Mr. Sam. Who? Sam Rayburn. I don't know what it was really bizarre. I'll tell you what. You talk about a humorless bunch of people. Congress.
No, man.
Bunch of stodgy, humorless people. No offense, Frank, but, I mean, he's the exception, obviously. He's funny. He's a guy.
Yeah, he is.
He's from Cheyenne, Oklahoma. They know how to laugh, right? People from Cheyenne? Oh, they know how to have a good time.
Oh, he knows how to swing the lead. Was that the Tom Jones song?
Yeah.
Or not?
Uh-huh.
Or something. 96.5 KECO, Nathan and Landry, and you text us 225-9697.
Do you think Frank is getting ready for the Cheyenne Rodeo?
Could you play Brick House by Lionel Richie? He didn't.
That was the Commodores, wasn't it?
Was it?
I think so.
The Commodores?
I think
Brick
so.
House?
Which included...
She's a brick house!
Which included Lionel.
Do we need a selection, Landry? Do you have a selection for us? Do you have something for us over there?
Lionel.
96.5 KECO, Nathan and Landry. And you, it is about 73 degrees outside. Muggy, Landry. We have some rain moving in.
Doubt.
Could be a rainy night in Georgia. I don't know.
Rainy night in Georgia.
Looks
remember when
like
Elvis sang that on the way out of the concert?
Today, 94, but tonight, 80% chance of showers and thunderstorms, low of 67. Tomorrow, 80% chance of rain, high of only 83 degrees tomorrow, Landry. You know this song makes me cry.
I've been alone.
Was this the tune Seinfeld would play when they were on the pier? Oh, that is poignant. Hey, 9 minutes after seven. Our goal is to keep you so updated as to the time that you couldn't possibly miss what time it was. It's time to let them help you. Help them help you. Will you help them help you? Because in 10 years or 20, you're going to want to stop working and be free. Just free as a bird to go do what you want, okay? It's not about getting rich. It's about stepping away from your job and still being able to go do what you want to do. Advanced Financial Strategies can help you put a plan together, and they will work the plan for you and with you so that you keep doing what you do, work your job, take care of the kids, you know, just live and let them work the plan. Advanced Financial Strategies, the website retirewithbacca.com.
Nathan, I am so excited. And I don't usually get excited, but I'm pretty excited about the weather forecast because I see that there is a chance, not just of rain, and that's good enough by itself, but there is a very high percentage of lower temperatures. I'm looking at a high tomorrow of around 80. That is super de-duper.
Yeah, it is. Your
I
weather
am so excited.
Breakdown coming up at the bottom. Tonight, what time is it going to be at about 7 o'clock this evening, Landry?
It's going to be 7. Exactly at 7 o'clock tonight. Tonight, I'm glad you asked, Nathan. Is this Thursday? Is this Wednesday? What day is today?
I can tell you that
it's going to be
7 o'clock
at 7
tonight.
O'clock tonight, it's going to be 90 degrees.
Okay, so for kickoff of Elk City versus Canadian, expect 90 degrees. Dress appropriately and accordingly.
Do they still do dress up at the ball games for the home games, every home game?
I don't know.
It's different every week. It's a different thing.
I don't know.
Dress in pink or dress like Kanye or wear your street crew clothing. You know, sometimes the kids wear the yellow vests and the hard hats. I'm not sure what that's about.
Boy, those high school
but
kids
they do it.
Can be crazy.
They do it, Nathan.
But is any high school group as crazy as Latham and Garrison in about 93?
When we were in high school, Nathan, did we have a designated pump-up person in the student section for the ball games? One person whose job it was to get the crowd fired up? because they do that now. And it's usually the class president, I think. But this year, something happened. The class president, I'm told, may be in the band. And so I believe he's delegated pumping up the crowd to someone else.
Sounds like a serious job for serious people.
Well, they're taking the job seriously, and they're also taking pumping up the crowd seriously.
How about what the back has said yesterday about Coach Higby at Clinton being a calculus teacher?
That's really something.
Yeah. Calculus. Wow. Clinton Reds. Did they say traveling to John Marshall tomorrow night? See, they don't have to worry about a rodeo in Clinton this weekend. They don't have to worry about it. There's no scheduling conflict
there. They don't do that at the amphitheater?
Not this weekend. I mean, maybe next, but not this weekend. Tonight, Elk City football kicking off the season against Canadian Texas, the Canadian Bacons. The Canadian Bacons. You know, I understand they're so nice in Canadian, but they have that northern accent that's funny. Elk City is hosting the Canadian Bacons at Running and Gunning Big Elk Stadium tonight. 6:30 pregame, 7 o'clock kickoff, BigElkTV.com and Cool 94.3.
Nathan, just before we went on the air, I found the board-approved Elk City Public Schools calendar for the entire school year. And according to my information, tomorrow, Friday, August 30th, Elk City Schools, it's blue on the calendar. And when you look down at the key, the legend.
Oh, he's a legend.
When you look at legend at the bottom, blue equals no school. Tomorrow, Friday, August 30th, on this board-approved Elk City Public Schools calendar, it's blue. That means no school tomorrow.
It would have been funny if you'd have had a John Legend song pulled up there.
I know.
And talked about the legend on the map. Oilfield companies need it. They're willing to pay for it. Farmers, they'll whittle you if they can on the price. Camrock knows that. They keep their prices as low as they can, and they get it to you as quickly as they can if they need to deliver it. Or you go into the place, look around, find what you need, buy it in bulk for an engine. Get it in bulk. Save money, save time. Camrock Supply, next to Fred's Steakhouse in Elk City. The website, camrocksupply.com. 96.5
As I was saying,
KCO.
Nathan, I looked at the legend on the board-approved Elk City Public Schools
what
calendar.
What would I do without your smart mouth?
And tomorrow drawing me is blue you on the calendar, and that means no school at Elk City tomorrow. They're having school today, no school tomorrow. So, kids, I am giving you permission to stay up late enough to watch all of the fourth quarter tonight at the football game.
All right, here we go. It's time for the Mangum Star News. Here we go. Tomorrow's edition today. Tomorrow's edition today. I'm divining this, Landry. I am looking into the future. And tomorrow, I predict that when the Mangum Star News comes out tomorrow, you will see a story about a burn ban in effect. A burn ban for Greer County was put into effect at Monday's meeting of the county commissioners. So be advised, you will read about a burn ban in effect tomorrow when the Mangum Star News comes out. Also tomorrow, return of the weekly Wednesday gathering starts next month. The First Methodist Church of Mangum will once again host their weekly Wednesday gathering Wednesday, September the 4th. Doors open at 10 a.m. Also on page one of the Mangum Star News that you will read about tomorrow, I call it tomorrow's news today, mobile wellness services to be in Mangum monthly. Oklahoma Human Service mobile offices will be in Mangum the fourth Monday of every month from 10:30 in the morning till 2:30 in the afternoon at the Greer County Courthouse. Each mobile office contains all amenities found in any county office and staffed by experienced family service specialists. You're going to read that tomorrow in the Mangum Star News. We're taking a look at it. Tomorrow's news today. Hike, crafts, and more planned at Quartz Mountain in September. Each month, the folks at Quartz Mountain State Park plan activities that are free and open to the public. This September, things start off with a chalk paint event. This Sunday, September 1, 9 to 3. There you go. Below that, a story about American Legion holding a taco dinner September 13th. Landry, oh, those tacos. The Paul Garrett American Legion Post 121 in Mangum is hosting its second annual taco dinner September 13th from 4 till 6 p.m. Voter registration for the November 5 election is October 11. Can I confuse you with some more dates, Landry?
Thank you.
You see, November the 5th, they say there's a big election in America. Well, the deadline to get registered to vote is October the 11th. That's according to Debbie Davis, Secretary of the Greer County Election Board. And that's going to be on page one of tomorrow's Mangum Star News. Also, there's a picture of a pothole patch. Didn't you work out in the pothole patch? Every pothole starts small and eventually gets bigger, which causes bigger issues for motorists. So they are patching potholes in Mangum, Oklahoma. You're going to read about that in tomorrow's edition of the Mangum Star News. The Tiger Bash to benefit Mangum Tiger Athletics. Join the fun downtown Mangum Square. Help benefit Mangum Athletics a week from today, Thursday, September 5. A week from today, Thursday, September 5, for the Tiger Bash. And now, Landry, I'm going to slide down the paper to page 8. Let's go to page 8, Landry, shall we? Shall we take a look?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I will as soon as I can get there. I went too far. Okay, here we go. First game of the Mangum Tiger football season is September 6th. I think that's a week from tomorrow. Yeah, it's a week from tomorrow. September 6th. It looks like Wilson, Mangum Tigers football. Class A Division II Mangum Tigers scrimmaged Frederick August 23, Velma Alma Thursday in prep for their first official game of the season. The Tigers will take on Wilson a week from tomorrow. Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And they've got the whole schedule. If you want to see the Mangum football schedule, that's on page 8. And then a picture of some of the team. I don't know if it's all the team or just some of the team. I don't know who we're looking at. Everybody's got their arms crossed and they look angry. So you can expect the Mangum football team this season to be angry. Because in this picture, they look angry with their arms crossed and there's some squinting. It was a sunny day. They've also got lake levels. Be looking for lake levels. Mangum's number one cheerleader. That's also in tomorrow's edition of the Mangum Star News. I call it, Landry. I call it. Tomorrow's news today. The Mangum Star News will be out tomorrow. I have given you a sneak peek. Mike Bush is the guy who puts it all together. Contact him at the office if you want to subscribe. If you've got a news tip, well, they like news tips. Mangum Star News out tomorrow. 96.5 KECO is the early morning show, 19 minutes after 7 o'clock. You like living healthy, don't you, Landry? I mean, you're a guy on the go.
Oh, yeah.
You're looking to the future,
no doubt about
but
it.
Appreciating the past.
Mm-hmm. Sure, but not overlooking the present.
But you're always so present. That's what I like about you. You look to the future, you honor the past, but you're always so present. If you like delicious food, but you want to live longer, you go healthy, okay? A lot of us really enjoy pizza, but maybe you don't want the carbs. In that crust. Oh, that wheat crust, Landry. It may be delicious, but you don't want the carbs. Mm. Well, what if there's even a more delicious alternative that lets you be healthier? What if you could taste something that is crunchy and delicious like it were fried, but it's not? It's still baked, and it's not a wheat crust. It is a gluten-free cauliflower-based crust. And you're saying to yourself, what? Cauliflower? Cauliflower tastes nasty.
Yeah, it does, just a little bit.
But a wheat cauliflower crust tastes nothing like cauliflower. And it doesn't have the gluten, and it doesn't have the carbs. But what it does have is that fried crunch. It's delicious. It is this gluten-free pizza at 66 to go on Highway 6 and 66. On the west side of Elk City.
Now.
Landry, it's rodeo time. We got to give away some rodeo tickets. We've got the worst majors to get into in college, right? The majors you regret.
We could.
Every once in a while we do that.
Hey, did you hear about what famous person's kid is playing football in Oklahoma?
Yeah, it's Matthew McConaughey.
Woodward.
Sons at Woodward.
Up at Woodward State.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, oh, they're playing ball up at Woodward. Oh, no. And tomorrow, it's Blue Day at Elk City Schools. You know what that means? No school.
OU kicks off its football season tomorrow. The odd, mistaken Friday game. I think it's a mistake, but whatever. They're playing tomorrow evening at 6 in Norman. And then South Dakota State is going to get a taste of some Oklahoma hospitality in Stillwater on Saturday. Elk City kicking off its season against Canadian Texas tonight. 6:30 pregame, 7 o'clock kick on Cool 94.3 and BigElkTV.com. Good morning to my favorite triplets, Landry, Nathan, and Landry. Oh, and good morning, Holly. And we did have a request for the pre-show. Somebody wanted some Stone Temple Pilots. We're working on
Nathan
that.
Nathan and Landry have to spray their throats with honey and lemon now. The Early Morning Show on KECO.
If they call me, they're expecting me to get whatever task done. To a farmer, a tractor, combine, gets him up and running. He's back in the field, makes some money. Guy in the oil field, their piece of equipment's running again. That makes some money. Solves that problem. I'm Brock Kalk, and my company is American Hose and Supply. We sell all types of industrial hose and fittings, oil field or agriculture. So if your farmer need a hose built, you can come in. We'll build it. You're an oil field customer and need us to come out and see you, we'll come out and see you and take an order or pick up a hose, build it, bring it back to you. If we're competitive on price, we say we'll bring it to you. We'll do whatever it takes to get it to you, make life easier on you. Or you can call us to solve a problem. Hey, can you get this? Why wouldn't you? My company is American Hose and Supply. Come by and see us at 2111 South Main, Elk City, Oklahoma, in Camrock Building next to Fred's. Or call me at 580-821-4413. 821-4413.
Everyone around me was drinking coffee, and I wanted to be a coffee drinker too. But everything I tasted was either too bitter or too sweet. So I tried one more place. Instead of just ordering, I told them an idea of what I wanted, and they crafted a drink just for me. It tasted fresh, like coffee is supposed to. The brew was mild, and the flavor not too sweet. Exactly what I wanted. They've done this for lots of people. They'll do this for you, too. Thanks to Twister's Coffee Company next to Brahms in Elk City, now I'm a coffee drinker. Every day.
The entire country is running on a credit card, and at some point, this bill has to be paid. Hi, this is Briley Baca with Advanced Financial Strategies in Clinton. Who do you think is going to get stuck paying for all this unnecessary government spending? If you think it's Uncle Sam, well, think again. If you have a 401k or an IRA, you have an IOU to the IRS. So all that money you've spent your entire life saving for your retirement is not all yours. If you hate paying taxes now, I promise you will hate them even more in retirement. If you're ready to permanently disinherit Uncle Sam from your retirement, call us at 323-6800 or schedule some time on our website, retirewithbaca.com. That's retirewithbaca.com.
Briley Baca is an investment advisor representative of and advisory services offered through Royal Fund Management, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor.
Isaiah 44, verses 2 and 24 say, "This is what the Lord says, He who made you, who formed you in the womb, and who will help you. Your Redeemer, who formed you in the womb. I am the Lord, the maker of all things, who stretches out the heavens, who spreads out the earth by myself." Mom and Dad, tell your kids it's okay to be different from the others. The most pressure-filled space in the world of a child is inside the four walls of a school building. It's easy for grown-ups to forget how much pressure there is for kids not to be different, to wear the clothes the others are wearing, to listen to the music the others are listening to talk and act like the cool kids. Tell them the coolest thing in the world is becoming the person God created them to be, not the person the world wants them to be. Raise your kids to stand out, to be kind, to work hard, and to please our Heavenly Father with good works and actions. Brought to you by Canyon Oilfield Services. Remember, the key word in Canyon Oilfield Services is service.
Fence building or welding? John Six will get her done. Six Wire Company. 580-497-6213.
Ready for another dose of radio caffeine? Here comes the Early Morning Show on KECO.
Now if we can get the 49 other states to do it, we'll save America. 96.5 KECO is the Early Morning Show, 26 minutes after 7 o'clock, about 73 degrees where we are. Skies are partly cloudy, humidity 71%, looking for a warm high of 94, which even that's better. Last couple of days have been better, still warm, but better. But man, tomorrow we get the 10 to 12 degree cool off. Going to feel nice, and we got a chance of rain, which we don't want any activities to be rained out, certainly, but we do need the moisture. I mean, am I right? 96.5 KECO is the Early Morning Show. Brock knows if you call, it's because you need something. And they get it to you as quickly as they can. They will build a hose for you, bring it out to your place. They recommend you get supplied ahead of time, and that way if something happens out on location, you got the supplies you need to get patched up and get back to work. American Hose and Supply is inside the Camrock Building in Elk City. next to Fred's Steakhouse. American Hose and Supply for all your hoses and fittings, because eventually they're going to break down. 821-4413.
Nathan, if you studied humanities, life sciences, or law in college, there's a better than 40% chance you regret that choice now. Which one of those did you study?
I don't think any of them.
Nathan, that was the takeaway from a report by the Federal Reserve, whose researchers perennially ask college graduates whether they would choose a different field of study if they were granted a do-over. If they were granted a do-over. The most lamented majors, social and behavioral sciences, regretted by 44%. I don't even know what that means. The social sciences, behavioral sciences. Okay, what does that mean? But 44% of people who have degrees in those fields or disciplines regret it. Followed by humanities and arts, 43%. Okay, what do you do with a degree in humanities and arts? What does that mean? Life sciences, 43%. Law, 41%. Does that mean law school?
I guess.
As far as I know, there are no bachelor's degrees in law. I don't know of any. Education, 38%. 38% of people who got a degree in education regret it. The least regretted fields, engineering, only regretted by 27%. Followed by computer and information sciences, 31%, and health, 32%. I think what we see is the degrees that are the most regretted pay the least. And the degrees that are least regretted pay the most. I think we see an inverse proportionality, Nathan.
Yeah.
So you see? You see, right?
But is it as important to get a degree in a specific field as it is simply to get a degree?
Probably not. The story goes on to say, of course, regretting your major is not the same as regretting college. The vast majority of college graduates with bachelor's degrees, more than 80%, say their education helped prepare them for a well-paying job, according to a May report from Pew Research.
96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. There's a story in the Oklahoman this morning about Oklahoma City schools. Oklahoma students are missing class and failing in reading. What's happening? It's about absenteeism in Oklahoma City schools, and people believe it's related to reading ability. Oklahoma's education system, chronically ranked among the lowest performing in the nation, is failing at even getting kids to come to school. Now, hold on. Did you hear what I just read in that first sentence? Oklahoma's education system, chronically ranked among the lowest performing in the nation, is failing at even getting kids to come to school. Now, call me naive. I may be simplistic. But isn't it the parents' responsibility to get the kids to come to school?
Wait a minute. You mean the school doesn't call your kids when it's time to wake up?
And then come get them at their house?
And compel them to get dressed and feed them and then drive them to school?
As far as I know, students are not assigned a body man to wake them in the morning, help them get dressed, feed them breakfast, and then drive them to school. Is there a correlation between absenteeism and poor performance? Absolutely. Landry, what is the number one indicator of a student's success in yours or any other college class?
Attendance.
If you show up, you're much more likely to succeed in that class.
Yeah.
Because you will hear the information about which you will be tested and graded.
That's what I tell my students every semester. If you show up, you'll do better.
Yeah. Significantly better. Well, in public school, it's the same thing, and specifically the story's talking about reading. And so there's a higher rate of absenteeism than schools would like, and with that, the students who don't show up have more trouble literally reading. Well, it makes sense, because in school you learn to read, and then do it, and then practice it. So you learn to read at school, and then you do the reading at school, and so if you don't show up, you're less likely to read well, and you're going to fall behind in reading. And if you fall behind in actually the ability to read, it's going to affect just about every other subject. Because even in science, I had to read stuff. Mm. In history, I had to read stuff. In English, I had to read stuff. Mm-hmm. So you're going to read in a lot of subjects. Math, The math's a little bit different because you got more numbers than words, but still, the information seems to be conveyed in words. You got to be able to read. And that means you need to show up. But Murray Evans is the one who wrote this story, and it's a half story, half opinion, I think. So I'm not sure if it's supposed to be a news story. But Oklahoma's education system, chronically ranked among the lowest performing in the nation, is failing at even getting kids to come to school. That's not the school's job to get kids there. That's mom and dad's job to get them there and to keep them there. I don't think you can hold a school responsible for absenteeism or truancy.
No.
Their job is to teach the kids once the kids are there. It's mom and dad's job to get them there. So I think it's unfair to blame schools for that. 96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show coming up on 7:33, partly clear skies. It's going to be cooler again today. And by cooler, I mean 94. It's still going to be warm. But now tomorrow, the 10-degree cool-off. You like candy? Mix and match candy at Atwood's, $3.49 a pound. How about those sparkling ice? I didn't know they had sparkling ice at Atwood's. They got sparkling ice. 17-ounce bottles, 5 for $5. Landry, I call that a dollar per. That's what I call it. Stay hydrated. Stay electrolyted. Assorted 28-ounce Gatorade. Usually $1.79. Right now, $1.49 at Atwood's. And by the way, Brian's Buy of the Week, all caps. Buy one, get one 50% off. Buy one, get one 50% off. Spinrow, Ariat, Troll Company, Hooey, Black Clover, Rural Cloth, and more. Ever gotten an and more cap? Buy one, get one, half price. Brian's Buy of the Week, Atwood's, Ranch and Home Goods, and I've got this information inside the latest penny news.
Nathan, I love the pre-rodeo ticket giveaway section of the show, which is right now.
Yes.
Is this your favorite all-time rodeo song?
They don't play this song.
They do in my rodeo theater.
No, they play Man, I Feel Like a Woman.
Yes, I know that.
Landry. They play Man, I Feel Like a Woman.
You're that guy.
Bridget says, you would be surprised how many people call the police department to get us make their children go to school. Tell you what I'd do to get my kids, give them a belt. Get my belt.
Have they considered a strongly worded letter?
Any man of mine.
Best part of this song is the beginning.
Oh, no doubt. One listener says, I honestly regret being a college dropout, but high school was the best 6 years of my life. Love playing football all those years. Have a great shift, fellas. Is this what you listen to before you ride the bull?
This is my walk-up music. When I'm up on that bull, this is what they play for me.
Yeah, I bet they do.
That is my walk-up music.
I bet they do. 7:35, Landry wasn't just shoveling manure, okay? We are going to give away some rodeo tickets in the next segment. Stay tuned for your chance. Stay tuned. Continue to tune in. Stay tuned. Stupid phrase. Hey, will you stay tuned? Are you going to tune in for that? Don't tune out.
So much confidence in that information we gave earlier because it was based on a board-approved Oak City Public Schools calendar.
Tomorrow night at the rodeo, if you don't think there won't not be F-150s there, you are out of your mind. Barbara Dyson Ford will be their premier sponsor of the Oak City Rodeo of Champions. In the meantime, if you want to go by the lot today, over 70 trucks there, touch them all. If you go inside, listen, yeah, there's a little construction going on. They're beautifying. Beautification and purification. But just step around it. Out on the lot, beautiful trucks. Barbara Dyson Ford Summer Blowout. It's on. BarbaraDysonFord.net. Man, seems like there's really some issues over there. Still, what was this, a week? Week and a half now? 2 weeks? Landry,
I had COVID and didn't know it.
Look ahead to not this weekend, but next. September 6 and 7 in Cheyenne, Oklahoma, Championship Red Dirt Rodeo. Tickets on sale now at The Den, Twisted Pearl Salon, Security State Bank, the Cheyenne Star Newspaper, Minnie Sleaf Library, and the Chamber of Commerce. You can also get your tickets online, eventbrite.com. Eventbrite.com. By the way, that's B-R-I-T-E. It's a little confusing, right? Tickets on sale now. It's the Championship Red Dirt Rodeo, September 6 and 7 in Cheyenne. And there you have it. Will says, I didn't need a college education. As long as I can read a wrench, I'm good. Text us at 225-9697. Coming up, your rodeo weather, your football weather breakdown, and we've got rodeo tickets to give away. Then Jared's got morning news. I'm Nathan.
I'm Landry.
Nathan and Landry will keep talking on the Early Morning Show right after this.
You got to break a few eggs to bake a cake, but the result is fantastic. We're remodeling Barber Dyson Ford, and you're going to love what we're doing at the place. But don't let the construction scare you away. We're not slowing down for one second. The lot is busting at the seams with more inventory than anyone from OKC to Amarillo, and we're determined to move it out so the prices are low and the trade-in cash is high. It's the end of the summer with construction sale at Barber Dyson Ford, where the remodel won't get in the way of your great deal. Online at BarberDysonFord.net.
Yeah, farmers can be pretty tough. Oilfield companies, they need it as long as we give them a fair price. Say, let's go. Farmers, they're pretty tough because it's a hard world in farming, you know, in the farming market. It's tough, so they're going to do all they can to get the best deal they can, and we're going to give it to them. Everything for maintenance on your equipment, changing your oils, you need some antifreeze, you need some hydraulic oil, any kind of grease. We got the bolts and fasteners now. We're opening up electrical fittings, zip ties, penetrating oils, you know, windshield washers, all your shop towels, hand wash stuff, you know, any type of stuff like that. Anything for like a maintenance shop or something like that where you're doing maintenance work. Just getting everything else that we can to make us a one-stop shop. And if we don't have it there, we're going to get it for you somehow or another. And it's not going to take 2 weeks to get it. Camrock is the name of the company. It's 2111 South Main, Elk City, south of Fred's Steakhouse. I'm Ronnie Redd. Myself, Brock Kalk, and Casey Miller are your owners at Camrock. Three local guys just looking to do business with our community.
Oklahoma Bank and Trust has been your community bank since 1908. For over 110 years, we've been working hard to serve the banking needs of the people in our community. At Oklahoma Bank, our customers aren't just account numbers, they're our friends and neighbors. We offer all the products and services you'd expect from a bank, from checking and saving accounts to loans for your home, auto, or business. Come by our Clinton or Arapahoe branch to discuss how we can tailor our offerings to meet your needs. OB&T, your friendly bank since 1908. Member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Usually the victim is doubled over with abdominal pain. But not this time. This time was a little different. The poor guy couldn't stop throwing up. It was Wednesday night, and it got so bad he went to the ER. Turns out he had kidney stones. On Thursday, he saw Aaron Doherty at Urology Associates Western Oklahoma. On Friday, Dr. Cole Wooten performed surgery. And just like that, the suffering stopped. Nearly one out of every nine adults will go through the pain of having kidney stones. It's a miserable condition to suffer through. If it happens to you, it's not a statistic, it's a painful fact. You want prompt assessment and prompt treatment. That's what Dr. Cole Wooten and urological nurse practitioners Tracy Lane and Aaron Doherty provide. On Facebook, search Urology Associates Western Oklahoma. The office is in Elk City at 522 North Main. When you're suffering, you want relief sooner, not later.
You get a cup of coffee, you walk up to the cashier to pay, and there it is, a world of possibilities right there at your fingertips. The Penny News, our free gift to you.
Your morning dose of information returns right now. Let's get back to the Early Morning Show on KECO.
Nineteen minutes away from the top, 96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. Nathan and Landry and you. The text line, 225-9697. Curvin and Mary Orgain will help you see the light of day, even at night. They own Carter Electric. Curvin and Mary Orgain and Carter Electric. 225-2447, bringing you the forecast this hour. Here we go. Today, mostly sunny, high near 94 degrees. South winds will be 10 to 20. But then tonight, Landry, we've got an 80% chance of rain moving in at some point. The winds are going to shift to the north, and the temperature is going to drop. We're looking for a low of 67 degrees. So tonight, today 94, which means at about kickoff tonight for the football game, Elk City versus Canadian, about 7 o'clock tonight should be about 90 degrees. But then at some point tonight, and hopefully late, the weather will change. We're going to have a front move in, bringing an 80% chance of rain, wind shifting to the north, dropping to 67 degrees. Tomorrow, 80% chance of rain early. Tomorrow afternoon's high, 83 degrees, and north winds 5 to 10. Tomorrow night, 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, low of 65. And then Saturday, Landry, 40% chance of rain and a high, 85. Right now on the back porch, it's about 74 degrees where we are. Sky's partly clear. Humidity, 71%, which is what it was yesterday. I wonder if our humidity machine's broken. My ambient weather machine says the humidity is actually 78%. A little sticky out there, partly clear. If you don't have a clue the name of the drink you want, or even if the drink exists, don't worry about it. If you know the flavors you like, that's all you need. Drive up, roll your window down, and say, hey, please put this in my cup. I want hot or cold, sweet or not, this flavor, that flavor, this strong, that strong. Twister's Coffee Company will just make you exactly what you want. They're next to Brahms in Elk City. That's Twister's Coffee Company next to Brahms in Elk City. 96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. Latest penny news. I'm looking at it. Oh, Landry, there's that gluten-free pizza I was talking about. Mm-hmm. Man, it's good stuff. I really like that. 66 to go. It's on page one of the penny news. An estate sale, not this weekend, but next, September 6 and 7, at 152 Calhoun in Elk City. The estate of Shirley Teague. Also, sod by Sherry on page one. Bob Bocamp Sand and Gravel LLC. Easy Haul Trailers at Everett's Welding and Repair. Woo! Good stuff in the penny news. And I'm looking at the latest. All right, Landry, the rodeo's this weekend. We've got two pair of tickets we're going to give away up first. Up first, Landry. I've got a pair of tickets for the Friday night performance. Tomorrow night, opening night. Pair of tickets for Friday night, opening night. Let's go with the song by the guy I told you about, the second one.
The second one.
Okay. I'm going to make this a little bit easy, I think. I've got a song. It's a theme song. Here's what I need to know. Who's the guy singing it? Fairly simple, I think. Who's the guy singing this song? First correct answer. You got to give me the answer and your name. 225-9697. Text me the answer and your name. Who's singing this song? 225-9697. First correct answer wins a pair of tickets for the Friday night performance of the Elk City Rodeo of Champions and a $50 gift certificate to Mountain Man's Axe Throwing and Pizza Pie.
Wow.
Yeah.
Out through New Mexico, drifting down to Santa Fe to ride a bull in a rodeo. He's hooked on a feeling, addicted to a natural high. Don't know why it's appealing, all he knows is he's got to ride. He's addicted to danger, ruled by passion and pride. To pain and fear he's no stranger, but his lust needs to be satisfied. Hooked on an 8-second ride.
Somebody's heart in a mess. 96.5 KECO.
Getting up down in back of the chutes. Makes that rosin burn. He's got his spurs on the heels of his boots. He's at the point of no return.
It's like when you get locked into the roller coaster and they strap you in. He's like, oh, I can't get up.
Do you think any bull riders ever get on a bull? Like, they're in the chute, they're in the bull, they're all strapped in, and then they change their mind.
Probably. Well, probably not the veterans. But it wouldn't surprise me if you get a teenager. Maybe it's his first time on the bull, and he, as soon as he gets on, he's No, can I get out? I'm done. No, no, no. I've changed my mind. You know what? Let's let somebody else go first.
Remember when Fonzie rode the bull? I almost said a crazy and amazing.
You feel okay?
What's in that coffee?
All right, we're asking what is the guy's, the singer's name here?
Are you gonna make
great
for spelling?
No, I won't. I'm not gonna laugh. Although they're spelled correctly by nearly everybody.
Are you telling me someone has correctly answered the question?
Yeah. A gentleman.
More than one?
Yeah, actually. A gentleman by the name of Will Lampshire is not singing this song, but Will Lampshire was the first person to tell us correctly who was. Lander, who's singing this song?
This is Mr. Chris Ledoux.
A worn-out tape of Chris Ledoux.
Man, Will Lampshire won two tickets, right? To tomorrow night's rodeo.
Oh, yeah.
And
a $50 gift certificate to Mount Man's Axe Throwing and Grub. Will Lampshire. I tried to make Wilshire two words. It's Will Lampshire from Lampshire Farms. They make that delicious sausage. Will Lampshire, congratulations. You've won yourself two tickets to Friday night's Oak City Rodeo of Champions and a $50 gift certificate to Mountain Man's Axe Throwing and Grub.
That sounds like a great date night. Go out to eat at Mountain Man's and then go to the rodeo.
Now, Lander.
All of it absolutely free.
We got to give away a second pair of tickets. This is for Saturday night performance of Oak City Rodeo of Champions and a Cinch gift certificate from Circle A Western Wear. Here we go. Saturday night, two tickets, Oak City Rodeo of Champions. I'm going to ask you a question. You're going to answer it 225-9697 and give me your name. We're going to play a song in just a moment. In fact, go ahead and fire it up. Now, there's a fictional conversation. There's a fictional conversation in this, which he's actually saying right now, and I'm going to talk over it so you can't hear it. There's a fictional conversation in the song.
If I ask you twice and beg you pretty please.
Okay, the characters in this fictional, or is it fictitional, conversation were from a TV show. What was the TV show? 225-9697.
He never hung his hat up at Kitty's place. I should have been a cowboy.
In this song by Toby Keith, huge hit, maybe the most played song of the 1990s. He starts it off with a fictional conversation between two TV characters. What was the TV show they were on? 225-9697. Text me the answer. First correct answer and your name. First correct answer and your name gets two tickets to the Saturday Elk City Rodeo of Champions. And a Cinch gift certificate.
Circle A Western Wear, the circle of quality.
Walker, Texas Rangers.
Young man, haven't you been told California's full of whiskey?
All right, you know what? I'm going to have mercy. Back it up to the beginning of the song again, and that way we will refresh memories. Fictional conversation between two people. What TV show were these two people on?
I'll bet you never heard old Marshall Dillon say, Miss Kitty, have you ever thought of running away? Settling down, would you marry me? If I ask you twice and beg you pretty please.
She'd have said yes in a New York minute. They never tied the knot, his heart wasn't in it.
He just stole a kiss as he rode away. He never hung his hat up.
Nathan, did you
at
tell
Kitty's
me?
Place.
Toby Keith intended
I
to be a songwriter.
I should have been a cowboy.
Yeah, he always considered himself personal, right?
I've never been a huge Toby Keith fan.
That's
a pretty good song.
Stealing
not the best
voice.
But boy, this was a huge
just
hit.
Like Gene and Roy.
I'm sorry. No, the answer was not Chris Ledoux. See what I was doing? See what I did?
See, he tapped into America's love of 1960s westerns. Actually, that show was on the air about 150 years.
Yeah, it was. It started in 1938, and it finally went off right after the Watergate hearings.
Did it start on the radio?
You know, it may very well have.
California's full of whiskey. Women and ghosts sleeping out all night.
Beneath the desert stars, a dream in my eye and a prayer in my heart.
Boundary, A Dream in His Eye.
I should have been a cowboy.
We're at page one.
I should have learned to roll and ride.
Or page three. Which one's the... Oh, no. Let me go back to page three. Let me go back to page four. Let me go back to page... Good night. We get a lot of people texting in here, Landry.
Well, people want to win rodeo tickets. Just like
Gene Roy. Yeah, we're playing for two tickets to the Saturday Elk City Rodeo of Champions and a gift certificate. A cinch gift certificate from Circle A Western Wear. In this song, Should Have Been a Cowboy by Toby Keith. Massive hit. His first... is just a huge hit in about 1993, I think. And he begins with a fictional conversation between two TV characters. I bet you never heard old Marshall Dillon say, Miss Kitty, have you ever thought of running away, settling down, marry me?
If I asked you twice, that'd be pretty pleased.
She'd have said yes in a New York minute. They never tied the knot. His heart wasn't in it. He just stole a kiss and rode away. He never hung his hat up at Kitty's place. Marshall Dillon and Kitty, or Miss Kitty.
You know, they tried to get John Wayne to play Marshall Dillon.
I know, right?
And he recommended the guy who finally wound up playing.
Well, a lot of you knew the answer. A lot of you are wanting these tickets. Ethan Delp was the first person to give us a correct answer. Later, what's the answer?
The answer is, what was the question? Oh, it was the question was, what's the TV show?
Yeah, what TV show were those two from?
Gunsmoke. Gunsmoke, Marshall Dillon, Miss Kitty, Festus, Chester...
The whole bunch. Doc.
Hoss.
Doc. Hawkeye. BJ.
Man Blocker.
Barney. Opie.
Uh-huh. Barney Miller. Otis Campbell.
Uh-huh. Kramer. They all showed up. They all showed up. How about that? Yeah. Ethan Delp was the first person to correctly answer the question. Ethan Delp, you've won yourself two tickets to the Saturday performance of the Oak City Rodeo of Champions, along with a cinch gift certificate. Please, I'm begging you, Will Lampshire, you know where we are. Ethan Delp, you probably do too. But if you've won tickets this week or last week and you haven't picked them up yet, we need you, N-E-E-D-J-A, we need you to come get them. Because believe me, if you won't come get them, we know plenty of people who will. So we're begging you, please come by KECO Radio. It'd be great if you can come today. If you've already won tickets, please come by today if you can, by 4 o'clock, and pick up your tickets. Because if there's any left here tomorrow, they're going to go to somebody else. They're probably going to go to somebody else, okay? We got plenty of people who want these tickets. So if you've won, come get them. Ethan Delp, congratulations. Will Lampshire, congratulations. Oak City Rodeo of Champions tomorrow night, 8 o'clock. Saturday night, 8 o'clock. Sunday night, 8 o'clock. Butler Brothers Arena. Oklahoma Bank and Trust, your friendly bank. Clinton and Arapahoe. The late, great Chris Ledoux knew all about them, I'm sure. Oklahoma Bank and Trust, Clinton and Arapahoe, your friendly bank. He knew how to ride the bull. I bet.
He's hooked on a feeling, addicted to a natural high.
Good morning, sunny and 74 outside. This is the Paragon Morning News. I'm Jared Athup. A tragic accident occurred on State Highway 136, 4 miles south of Groover, Texas, resulting in the deaths of two truck drivers on Tuesday afternoon. One of the victims was from Clinton. According to the Texas Department of Public Safety, the crash involved two semi-trucks and took place at approximately 2:22 in the afternoon. Authorities identified the drivers as 56-year-old Mark Ray of Clinton and 20-year-old Adrian Cisneros of Perryton, Texas. Both men were pronounced dead at the scene by the Hansford County Justice of the Peace. DPS officials stated that the collision occurred when Ray, driving a 2021 Peterbilt truck tractor, was traveling westbound on a farm road. Investigators believe he disregarded a stop sign at the intersection of State Highway 136, colliding with the Cisneros vehicle, a 2001 Freightliner truck tractor, which was heading northbound. Both vehicles caught fire upon impact. The Texas Highway Patrol said it remains unclear whether either driver was wearing a seatbelt due to the extensive damage caused by the crash. Texas Highway Patrol troopers are continuing their investigation into the incident. No other injuries were reported. More information has been released regarding the investigation into the deaths of dozens of horses at a Western Oklahoma rodeo stock contracting business. It was announced that the Oklahoma Department of Agriculture is investigating the deaths of horses owned by Butler & Son Rodeo Company. Veterinarians believe that the horses, which come from deep generational lines, were given faulty feed. An estimated 40 to 70 horses have died. The Oklahoma Department of Agriculture is investigating the feed, which came from Kansas after receiving a call from a concerned veterinarian. An inspector from the department visited the ranch on Monday to collect feed samples. However, the cause of death will not be known until the test results come in a couple of weeks. Butler & Son supplies horses to rodeos across the country and has done so for nearly a century. The timing of the incident couldn't be worse, with the Elk City Rodeo of Champions taking place this weekend. However, it has been reported that other contractors have graciously offered their stock to ensure the rodeo goes on as planned. Love these stories and more on our Facebook page and website. Once again, sunny outside in 74. This has been the Paragon Morning News. I'm Jared Aitha.
A person who has never smiled can start smiling. There's just a look on their face that completely changes. When we give them a mirror and show them their new smile, there's nothing that warms my heart more. I had a gentleman in his 50s, and his whole life he never had a front tooth. His front tooth was stuck up in the bone. He had been to dentist before, but nobody really talked to him about his options. That was just the most rewarding thing, and afterwards he sent me the sweetest card about how the Lord put a smile on his heart, but I put a smile on his face, and that's pretty rewarding.
I'm Dr. Jamie Cameron at Southwest Dentistry and Cosmetics in Weatherford, and on Mondays at Liberty Dental in Carnegie. Our website is swdentalok.com, or just Google us.
Southwest Dentistry and Cosmetics, where we treat you like family and do life-changing dentistry. And I've got to say, it's pretty life-changing for us whenever we see you with your new smile.
We rent most everything, from backhoes to mowers to lifts and chainsaws. DJ's Rentals and Sales, 225-1400, on South Main in Elk City.
Yeah, baby, 96.5 KECO in Leedy, Oklahoma. If you're hungry tomorrow night or Saturday night and you like tender Angus beef cooked to make it even more tender, topped with clarified butter, garlic-infused clarified butter, and seared. Man, ranchers sure know how to cook steak. Dry Creek Steakhouse and Lodge in Leedy, Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday for lunch. We got a football game tonight, Landry.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't think Elk City won't not play the Canadian Bacons at 7 o'clock, you're crazy. 6:30 pregame, 7 o'clock kick, Cool 94.3 and BigElkTV.com.
It's a good thing there's no school tomorrow.
Landry is correct. Gunsmoke began as a radio program. William Conrad was the voice of Marshall Dillon.
Wobby dog.
Congratulations. Ethan Delp and Will Lampshire won tickets today. Hey, we do have a bunch of tickets we've given away this week that haven't been picked up yet. Please, if you can, come by today, latest tomorrow noon. Because if you don't, we got plenty of folks we can give them away to. 96.5 KECO Elk City.
Hello. Here's a station you might like.
This is KECO Elk City.
Getting back out there, I'm Chris Foster, Fox News. President Biden's been away from the White House since his convention.